Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute. So we are continuing with the WBCS series, and today we will be discussing on spectroscopic technique. So let me start with the definition of spectroscopy. So before we start anything, we should know the definition. Now what is spectroscopy and what is the use of spectroscopy? Suppose you have a matter, this is a material. Now you put light on it, either light or other electromagnetic wave. Now what are electromagnetic waves? That may be X-ray, that may be UV light, that may be visible light, that may be gamma ray. Or that may be some other electromagnetic wave. So whenever this electromagnetic wave interacts with the matter, then some changes happen. Why does this happen? Because of the any material has some natural frequency or some other property. Because of that, this matter and this light or electromagnetic wave interacts, and because of the interaction we get some responses, and those responses we record somewhere, and that gives us some information about the material. Okay, so that is the basic logic of spectroscopy. Now we have several kinds of spectroscopy. First of all, say mass spectroscopy. Say NMR spectroscopy. Then we have UV visible spectroscopy. We have infrared or IR spectroscopy. We have Raman spectroscopy. And we have XRD, X-ray diffraction method. Now we need to know what are those techniques and what are their uses. Okay, so first of all we come to mass spectroscopy. Now what is mass spectroscopy? This is a spectroscopic technique which gives us idea about the molecular weight of the material, molecular weight and molecular weight distribution of the material. Now NMR spectroscopy, what is NMR spectroscopy? Let me tell you. Suppose we have a material, and the material is consisting of atoms. Now this atom has a nucleus, and surrounding it, it has shells where electrons move. Now what happens whenever electron has a negative charge? You all know. Now when it moves, basically what happens in the opposite of this movement, current flows, because current is nothing but the flow of charge. So now we are convinced that there are current flowing inside a material. So that is a current. Now you again know whenever a current flows, a magnetic field generates. Now in NMR what we do, we take a material. That material has some magnetic moment or magnetic field because of this movement of electrons. Now we impose an external magnetic field, say B external. Now this external magnetic field interacts with this inherent magnetic field and gives some response. If these two magnetic fields actually interfere and give us some response, and that response changes with changing the material. Suppose we change a material A to B, then the magnetic field strength of A and B would be different. So the interaction would also be different, and this is so much accurate, a minute change can be detected by this methodology. So basically what we did in proton NMR, we detect the kinds of proton in a molecule we have. Suppose we have methane. The structure of methane is like this. we have 4 equivalent, all those atoms are equivalent. So if you put methane in NMR, you will get only one peak. Now if we have another molecule which has different kinds of protons, we will get different kinds of peaks. So from this peak we can analyze the material and we can get some information about the material, or what material is this. So this is the NMR spectroscopy. So what are the questions you can expect from NMR spectroscopy? There might be a question that NMR spectroscopy is based on, options will be like it is based on magnetic field, it is based on electric field, it is based on blah blah blah. So the answer would be magnetic field or interference of the magnetic field. Now coming to UV spectroscopy, UV and visible spectroscopy. Now in UV and visible spectroscopy, what we do, there are some kinds of organic molecules which has organic molecules which has alternating single bond and double bond. Okay, so this is the molecule having alternating single bond and double bond. Now people are saying this arrangement can be like this also instead of that. So this electron cloud, we can say it is delocalized, or we can say electron cloud is moving like this way. From here to here, if we want to come, then we have to move the electron this way. So this is called delocalization, of pi electrons. Now what is pi electrons? Whenever there is double 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 bond, then this is a sp2 bond. Now in sp2 what happens, there are 3 hybridized orbitals and 2 p orbitals with this remaining perpendicular to it, and it is forming the pi bond. So this pi electrons is loosely bound and it can be moved, and that is called the delocalization of electrons. So now this system is called a conjugated system, where you have alternating single bond and double bond. Now the extent of conjugation changes the energy of the molecule, and that can be detected by UV spectroscopy. Suppose this delocalized electron cloud has some energy, and that falls in the range of UV and visible region. So if you put UV or visible light on it, it would respond. So if it is coming in the range of UV, then UV light would work. If it is coming in the range of visible, then visible light would work. So I will give you one example. Suppose carrot, it is red in color, you know. Now why carrot is red? Because it has carotenoids, which is a pigment, and which has conjugation. There is a large chain, you can see the structure of carotenoid is a long chain having alternating single one and double one. Now this single and double bonds are in resonance, and that gives an energy that falls in the visible range or red light range. That means around 800 nanometer. That is the wavelength of red light. Nanometer. That's why carrot is red. So like that way you have different flowers which has this conjugated system, and that's why they give beautiful colors. Based on the conjugation, it gives different colors. Suppose the same flower, sometimes it is white, sometimes it is red, and sometimes some other color. So everything depends on the conjugation system, and we can detect this conjugation system by the UV visual spectroscopy. Now what is IR spectroscopy? IR spectroscopy is nothing but the same thing, the interaction of the material with the infrared light or infrared electromagnetic wave. Now, what do we detect by this IR spectroscopy? We detect the functional groups in a molecule, organic molecule. We detect functional groups. What happens? Suppose we have an alcohol. Suppose we have ETOH. Now, this OH group will give you a particular peak in IR, say 3500 centimeter square in centimeter inverse, you get a peak, and this is a peak for OH. For every functional group, say you have a ketone group, say you have a aldehyde group, say you have a amine group, say you have a amide group, so all these things will give you different peaks, and you can distinguish and you can detect or you can have an idea what are the groups there in the molecule, and from there you can guess the structure of the molecule. So this is the importance of IR spectroscopy. Raman also gives the same thing. You can get information about the molecule. This is also interaction of light and matter. Now what is exactly? The X-ray diffraction method. This is basically used to detect whether the molecule or whether the matter is crystalline or non-crystalline. If it is crystalline, then it responds differently. If it is non-crystalline, then it does not respond. So if it is crystalline, you will get some peak. In XRT, if you are getting some peak, that means this is crystalline. If you are not getting a peak like that peak you are getting, that means this is amorphous. So here in this lecture, you came to know what are the spectroscopic topics and what are their uses. So there might be multiple questions from this spectroscopic technique, and nowadays this kind of questions are coming. That's why I made this video. I hope this video will help you, and I will be making more videos like this. And please subscribe to our channel. We will be uploading regular videos, and that might be helping you for your preparation. Thank you.